Okay dear, once again I'll discuss the further thing. So now I'll start discussing the concentration of the solution. So before discussing the concentration of the solution, we must discuss the solution. What is solution? So earlier I have studied solution is nothing but it's a homogeneous mixture of two and more than two components. But here we'll discuss only those kind of solution which will have only two components. That means we'll discuss binary solution. So solution is nothing, it's a homogeneous mixture of two or more solution whose concentration can be varied within certain limits. That means amount of the solute can be changed. Like you make a sugar solution. In sugar solution what we do? It is not, you suppose that you have to prepare one glass of sugar solution. In that one glass of sugar solution, how much sugar has to be added? It all depends upon the people, that how much sweetness you want. Somebody wants more sweetness, then more solute is added to the one glass of water. Somebody wants less amount of sweetness, so less amount of sugar is added to it to get the homogeneous solution. So that means there concentration is varied. Their concentrations are varied. That means concentrations are not fixed in case of homogeneous mixture. It depends upon the people that what kind of solution they want. So that's why the concentration of the solutions are variable. Now binary solution. What is binary solution? The binary solution are those solutions which have only two components, means one solute, one solvent. Only two components like the sugar and water, it is a binary solution. When you mix the sugar into the water, then it is a binary solution. When you mix the salt into the water, it is a binary solution, because only two components are together here. So it is called binary solution. So what is solute? In binary solution, the component which is in less amount, which is in a smaller proportion, which is in a smaller proportion are known as solute. So in case of sugar and water, sugar is the solute because amount of sugar in comparison to the water is very less. So that's why in case of sugar solution, sugar is the solute, whereas the water is solvent. So that means in binary solution, the component present in the larger proportions are known as solvent. So now it is clear that what is solute and solvent. Now we'll discuss the concentration, how many types, the way, how many ways we can express the concentration of the solution. How to express the concentration of the solution? Very first, the most trivial, the most older expression of expressing the concentration of the solution, that is the mass percentage. In mass percentage, what we find? We find that the amount of solute in gram. We always take amount of solute in gram, dissolved in 100 gram of solution. In a 100 gram of solution, how many grams of solute is present, that is called mass percentage. It is already discussed in class 9 and we have solved so many numericals over it. So no need to discuss in detail here, just revising. So mass percentage is nothing but it is a ratio of mass percentage to the mass of the solute to the mass of the solution in gram. Mass of the solute in gram to the mass of the solution in gram in 200. This is the formula of the mass percentage of the solution. This is the most older one to express the concentration of the solution. Okay. So this is the first way. Now in another way, that is the mole fraction. Mole fraction is a fraction, name itself tells you it must be ratio. Fraction means ratio. So mole fraction means ratio of the mole. Mole fraction means ratio of the mole. Now decide what kind of fraction it is. So mole fraction is nothing, it's a ratio of number of moles of any component, any one component. Ratio of the number of moles of any one component to the total number of moles of the solution. That means here you have to find out the ratio of the moles of any one component present in the solution, and it is to be compared with the total number of moles of the solution. Solution means it contains solute as well as solvent. So that is why the total number of moles of the solution would be the number of moles of the solute plus number of moles of the solvent. So it has to be compared with the total number of the mole of the solution. Now we'll take a particular component, say A, which we consider it as a solute, and say that number of moles of the solute is Na. That means number Na amount of solute is present in the solution, and the amount of solvent, we have taken the solvent B, number of moles of the solvent Mb. Now AB is the solution. When A and B are mixed together, so you get the homogeneous mixture. So that is why it is AB is now solution. So what is the number of moles of the solution? NAB. And in this NAB must be equal to the sum of these two, because these two only makes this solution. So that's why NAB equal to Na plus NB. Now the mole fraction of one of the component A, there are two components here. So first component A we'll talk about. Mole fraction is denoted by capital X. Mole fraction is denoted by capital X. So mole fraction of A would be denoted by XA like this, equal to number of moles of the component, that is Na, to the total number of moles of the solution, NAB. So NAB must be replaced by Na plus NB. So now you get Na plus NB. Now the mole fraction of the B, component B, second solvent. Again, there is same kind of ratio. Number, it is expressed by XB, and number of moles of the component to the number of moles of the solution, NAB. So NB by Na plus NB, it is replaced by Na plus NB. So now these two are the mole fraction of component A and B. Now we have taken, and there is a universal truth. Here we have talked about only two component in a solution. Even you have got more than two component in any solution and find out the mole fraction of each and every component in a solution and add all the mole fraction together which belongs to the same solution, it will be equal to 1. And here we have taken only two components, very easy to add. So mole fraction of the component A and mole fraction of component B, when you add it together, you will get 1. It is a universal truth. Sum of all the mole fraction, sum of mole fraction of all the components, sum of mole fraction of all the components present in the same solution are always 1. So here only two components, A and B. So sum of the mole fraction of component A and B is 1. So XA plus XB equal to 1. So during calculation, sometime one of the mole fraction is known to you, another can easily be calculated because total mole fraction would be 1 only. So that is why XA equal to 1 minus XB, and XB equal to 1 minus XA. To find out the value of XA, take this one this side, it will become minus. So 1 minus XB. To find out this XB, take this XA this side, it will become minus. It will be XB equal to 1 minus XA. So in this way, if one of the mole fraction is available in the question, then other mole fraction can be find out easily. No need to go into the details of the formula. Simply you compare with the one and you will get the second mole fraction also. So now you have understood mole fraction. I will discuss further in the next lecture.